Jon Batiste, I mean, this is one of the versions that I've gotten to know more recently. I mean, it's from 2020. He first did it for his album Social Music, with, you know, again, music bringing the community together. And I think jazz is a music that brings people together. So his version of the anthem is a kind of musical history of America. I mean, it has chords by Gershwin. It has, you know, sort of gestures to Jelly Roll Morton, one of the early jazz greats. You know, there's a way in which all of American music history is sort of in his fingers. And one of the things he does is he's inspired by the Black national hymn, Lift Every Voice and Sing. You know, which has really sort of risen in the public consciousness in the past 4 or 5 years as a sort of a symbol of the Black Lives Matter movement. So bringing the anthem together and sort of infusing it with the energy of Black American music through the combination of those two songs is incredibly powerful. And for me, you know, you have like Feliciano and Houston and Aretha Franklin, people who stylistically have updated the anthem, but it's Hendrix and Batiste, really, who take other musical symbols sort of compositionally. They're thinking of their arrangement as a kind of kaleidoscopic sort of assembly of American musical gestures, of sonic ideas, and they're bringing that all together into a new version of the anthem. And for me, that's what keeps it alive. I mean, the anthem for me is a living document. It's not something that's like this dead, static symbol that's talking about the past. Every time we sing it, we're asking that question anew, like, oh, say, does that Star-Spangled Banner still live? Are we brave enough to embody those ideals of freedom, equality, sort of the things that this nation is built around? They're often like, you know, just meaningless words that we just throw around. We forget to connect with them. But for me, the anthem, because we have to sing it, because we have to bring it to life every time in song, because we have to embody it ourselves, it's a call to us to fulfill those ideals, to sort of a call to citizenship, if you will, you know, to sort of take action ourselves to make this country what we want it to be. So we are asked that question anew, and we can give a new answer.